In this video, I'm going to demonstrate how to use triggering with Q cameras with help from a Q external triggering board. As of early 2010, the Q triggering board is now mounted in a box housing. To gain access to the triggering mode switches shown in this video, simply remove the four outer screws on the two sides of the box. So, let's get started. The Q triggering board accepts two forms of power, a standard 9-volt battery or an external power supply. I have a power supply, so I'll use that. Next, connect the triggering cable to the board. Now we'll connect B and C cables to the sync A and sync B ports on the board. These lines report the camera's status. We'll talk more about that later. This third B and C port is for use with external hardware. For example, you could use a waveform generator to construct the triggering waveforms for you. For more information, refer to the triggering board application note. Now the board's all hooked up, let's set up the camera. Connect the power cable, the other end of the triggering cable, and finally your computer data link cable. For this camera, it's a FireWire connection. The triggering board supports three different methods of triggering. Manual mode lets you generate triggering signals by pressing a button. In continuous mode, the board automatically generates the triggering signal. You can change the timing of this signal by adjusting the little knob on the potentiometer labeled P1. Finally, in external mode, the board will listen to signals generated by external hardware connected to the board. In order to select a mode, you must slide the little switch into the on position. Let's go into manual mode and then set up the camera for external triggering. In your camera software, in my case QCapture Pro, we must tell the camera to look for an external trigger. In the camera configuration, we can choose many different trigger types. These change how the camera will react to our triggering signal. Edge high, edge low, pulse high, and pulse low are some of the basic options here. Let's go over what they mean.
First off, the triggering signal is what is called an actively high signal. This means that because we're in manual mode, when the button is pressed, the signal will go from a high state to a low state. So, in edge high mode, when the button is pressed and then released, you've made the triggering signal go from low to high. Thus, edge high. At each instance of this low to high transition, the camera will take a picture with the exposure time set in your camera software. In edge low mode, when the button is pressed down, a transition from high to low is created. The camera will capture an image at each of these transitions. Now, pulse mode is quite different. In pulse high mode, the camera actually begins exposing immediately. You can interrupt each exposure by pressing the button down, but the length of each exposure is determined by how long the button is released.
Pulse low mode is just the opposite. The exposure time for each frame is determined by how long you hold the button down.
Using either pulse mode allows you to capture several images in sequence of varying exposure times.
In addition to changing the trigger type, the sync B line can also be configured.
There, we have two options, expose and trigger mask. Using the expose option, the sync B line will report when the camera is currently exposing a frame. The trigger mask option will report when the camera will accept the next trigger.
Once you set the triggering and sync B options, you'll need to go back to the main screen and set the exposure time if you selected edge mode. Then click snap so the camera is ready to accept your triggering signal. Now that triggering is all set up, let's go over an example of all the events that occur. Here we can see the trigger line, the sync B line, and the sync A line. As we can see, the camera begins exposing with the rising edge of the trigger signal, as we would expect when we're in edge high mode. When the exposure is finished, the camera begins to read out that image. When complete, the camera is ready for the next trigger event. A second trigger event is detected and the camera begins exposing. However, a third trigger event is sent during the current exposure. This event will be ignored. The final two triggering events are not in conflict with the camera, and their images are taken without issue. When integrating multiple pieces of hardware with your imaging application, it is recommended to create timing diagrams like this one in order to aid your setup. For more information and diagrams, please refer to the Triggering Board application note available on the QImaging website.